This series is funded by fans like you.
Wow, this place is amazing. How does a student afford this, if you don't mind me asking?
I don't. It's my aunt's. She's in Hong Kong for a year on a contract, and I get to host it.
Lucky you.
I know I am. Rose?
Hey. Yeah, come on up.
Great, she's here?
Yeah, she is. Oh man, I hope it went well.
Yeah, me too. I'm a little nervous that we maybe overinvested on this.
Have you met her? The new Vanessa?
New Vanessa. No, but I did see her, and looked like they had chemistry.
That's good. She wouldn't tell me anything. Oh, come in, it's open!
It is so cold outside.
Okay, wine or beer?
Whatever you're drinking.
Cheers.
Post.
Oh, wait. Salut. Okay, sit.
Fine. It was nice.
Nice?
Very nice. I don't know what you want me to say.
Why don't you start from the beginning?
I feel like I'm being interrogated.
You are.
Yes, absolutely. And he's the good cop.
Wait, so that makes you the bad cop?
Obviously.
All right, tell us, lady. Tell us everything and don't leave out any details or we'll know.
Okay, well, I was early. Which was a mistake, because that just made me more nervous. She got there precisely on time.
So, how did you greet her?
A hug? A smile? A firm handshake?
I don't remember.
Come on, Rose.
Anyways, we got going. It was so nostalgic right away. Those red, green, blue semicircles where we used to eat our lunches on field trips.
Lunchboxes.
Man, my dad would always chaperone. That's adorable.
It was nostalgia city for both of us. Like those bird stickers on the windows? That was the first place I'd ever seen them or knew what they were for. The next level down is for little kids now, but they still have that Rube Goldberg-like machine. We spent forever playing with it. We tried every option with it and followed the ball all the way. After we pulled ourselves away from that, I guess it was around then that I started realizing what a great conversationalist she is. She is a bit of a science geek.
So, it wasn't romantic?
Well, wait. Let me go on. We got to the science arcade, which is the part I remember best from school trips. Like the plasma ball, which I was too afraid to touch when I was a kid. The tornado simulator. The forced perspective ladder thing. The cave that Desiree and Eli got caught kissing in, which has a camera now, by the way. We had fun. Just good old fun. We raced each other on the electricity generating bikes, which I'll add, I totally kicked her ass on. We timed it perfectly for the electricity show, with the Tesla machine and that static ball.
Tell me you got to have your hair stand on end.
I did.
Head up and down.
Hey, Nessa, get up.
Oh, she has more hair. There you go.
That's smooth.
Smooth?
Well, she had to hold your hand, right?
Well, yeah, she had to. You had to hold tight or we'd shock each other. I was actually pretty terrified.
Do you see it between your fingers yet? There it is.
I think next was this Innovation Center thing. Weston family something? This must be newer. I don't remember it as a kid. There were were some good get-to-know-you activities in there, like a would-you-lie-to-me thing. Turns out she's an open book. Me? Not so much.
That's surprising.
What about the rainforest?
Definitely. I think this was the part I was looking forward to most. You have to be careful, though. It's slippery in there. I love the air in there. It's so hot, and the air seems so pure. We ended up being in there for quite a while. It was comfortable. Like, we didn't even need to say anything. It was like you said last night. We weren't forced to do any stupid small talk. We got to talk about science. About the world. About the human body. About social issues. It was really refreshing to just get to enjoy science stuff. Whereas in high school, What?
Did you talk?
Yeah, that was like all we...
Did you get to know her?
Oh, okay, I see what you're getting at. And in that way, no. But I did discover that she was a really nice person.
Well, do you like her?
Here's the thing. I had a really great day. We had a ton of fun, and she is a really cool person.
There's a butt coming. I'm sensing a butt.
But I didn't find it to be romantic. In fact, that was probably the reason why I was able to just let go and have a good time. We were just two girls having fun. There was no expectations about what we were or what we were going to be. That was, of course, right up until when we were leaving.
I always remember the Science Center as being a kids-only place.
No, it's for everyone. They even have adult-only nights in the summer now.
Really?
Yeah, we should go.
You know, I was really nervous about today, but I actually had a really great day. Thank you so much for suggesting this.
No, thank you. Today's been really magical.
Magical?
And then she kissed me out of nowhere.
All this time, you thought it was platonic?
And that's not even the part that really freaked me out.
I feel like I'm floating.
Huh.
Hmm.
It was really...
Surprising?
Overwhelming.
Overwhelming.
Yeah, and surprising.
Oh.
So... Now what?
I don't know.
Do you want to see her again?
I don't know. I mean, like I said, I had a really great day, and... Best day ever. Still floating. She put XO. I don't get it. I mean, we had a great day, we really did. And I think she's super cool. Could I have misread her? All day?
Or anything, but I feel like that's a possibility.
So what now?
Rose, you don't like her, and that's okay.
There's such an imbalance.
I've been on the wrong end of that too many times.
I've been on both sides of that before. There's no wrong or right side.
I just feel so bad that I'm not reciprocating.
You have no responsibility to reciprocate. It's fine if you don't have the same feelings as her, and it's fine later if you do.
It was the same way with Claire, wasn't it?
Ugh.
Sorry.
What is it with this Clara girl?
Oh, Claire. Right. She found a friend at the airline and she was able to snag a super cheap ticket home.
So she's coming.
Yep. She's coming.
So you get to meet Claire. Great. Great.
Thank you.
Oh, it's my dad. He wants to know how the date went, too.